charge can get them back to school.
Master Charge from First National Bank in Dallas, the school supplier.
Headlining this hour's top stories, Vice President Agnew says the United States will continue to supply military aid to Cambodia. The 52nd National Convention of the American Legion opens in Portland, Oregon today. Authorities have gone to unprecedented lengths to deal with anti-war demonstrators. The Senate expected to vote about noon today on a proposal that would limit defense spending to $66 billion. Richard Mark, KLIF, Fun Day News.
Along the high road came a marching soldier. One, two, one, two, one, two, one, two. You see, he had been to the wars and now he was on his way home. But pretty soon, he met an old woman. She was really a witch. She stopped him and said,
Charlie and Harrigan each morning.
Hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I do, Mary Lou. We never part. So hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. You passed me by one sunny day. Flashed those big brown eyes my way. And ooh, I wanted you forevermore. I'm not one that gets around. Swear my feet stuck to the ground. And though I never did meet you before, I said hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I knew, Mary Lou, we never part. So hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Your lips, I heard your voice. Believe me, I just had no choice. While horses couldn't make me stay away, I thought about a moonlit night. Arms around you good and tight. That's all I had to see for me to say. Hey, hey, hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I knew, Mary Lou, we never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. Yes, hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart.
Hello, Mary Lou. That's your favorite right there, Mary Lou, wherever you are today. That's Ricky Nelson, and this is Charlie Brown with Irving Harrigan, and we're in the Concourse Studios at 8 minutes after 8 o'clock.
And we're expecting, by the way, a report from Herman Wurlitzer, who is out in... we may be able to raise him right now. I don't know if he...
I think they say on the prowl, don't they, when they're out?
Is that what they say in the journalistic chalice?
I'm in the locker room, they say.
Red Adair puts out oil well fires.
So when we go in there, we work as a team, and we can make it.
How hot is it today?
Oh, it gets so hot the stand turns to glass. And you can drink all of the water in the world and it won't help you. Can I tell you about drinking beer? It was used.
Red cools off with cold Burl beer. Try Red Adair's cool kit. A couple of six packs of good Burl beer.
And you better know it tastes good when you're out there.
Look for Red Adair's cool kit featured at stores now. When you've made it, make it Burl.
Is there any way we can get him on? Can we just, you know, throw the thing from here? Does he have to do it?
I just,
I could throw it over here at the wall. I could throw the big point to the wall.
That turns the lights on. Is there any way we can get Herman on the air?
Claude, just sit down, please.
Why don't I just sit down over here?
Fold your hands, okay?
I don't know how to do that.
Never mind. Let's see if we can get Herman on.
I imagine if we just open the microphone to the mobile unit, we could probably pick him up, and we don't even have to tell him he's on.
We'll probably the best way to do it.
Let's try it and see what happens, all right? Let's just ease it open and see.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. It's on.
Charlie and Harrigan, the back of the Irrigan, for you and for me, on Cliff and Big D. Watch where you're going, fella. good to be back. Hey, look out! Oh, boy. Good to be back at Big D again.
Well, he's out there, and he'll no doubt give us a report very shortly.
Hopefully he will have some kind of a report. Brothers Four.
Ooh, ooh, a time to be reaping, a time to be sowing. The green leaves of summer are calling me home. 'Twas so good to be young then, in the season of plenty, when the catfish were jumping as high as the sky. A time just for planting, a time just for plowing, a time to be courting a girl of your own. 'Twas so good to be young then, to be close to the earth, and to stand by your wife at the moment of time to be sowing, a time just for living, a place for to die. 'Twas so good to be young then, to be close to the earth. Now the green leaves of summer are calling me home. 'Twas so good to be young then, to be close to the earth. Now the green leaves of summer are calling me home. Boy,
it's good to hear that.
Good to hear that again. The Green Leaves of Summer from the motion picture Alamo. You remember that, by the Brothers Four on a Charlie and Harrigan program on a Friday morning, and a pretty nice one, too. 72 degrees, and it's 13 minutes after 8 o'clock, and the weather headlines are brought to you by Skillerns, and they go like this. Fair through tomorrow, except for some afternoon cloudiness, warm days and cool nights, a high both days in the low 90s, and a low tonight of about 68, and right now we have 72 degrees.
Whoever you are, high school freshman, it's Skillerns for back to school.
Yes, there is a place where you can do all your back to school shopping and do it conveniently and at very little cost. Your neighborhood Skillerns drugstore. That's where it's at for back to school. Whatever you want, from ordinary paper and pencils to such high fashion equipment as matching binder notebook ensembles, from groovy tote bags to Crayolas, from colorful paper mate pens to students' desk lamps, from Archie binders to Elmer's glue, from Betty Ann nylons and pantyhose to fashion belts, Skillerns has it, and has it in huge selections at low, low prices. So why waste time shopping around when Skillerns has it all?
Whoever you are, a mere beginner, scholarship winner, it's Skillerns for back to school.
Okay, and right now we're 14 minutes after 8 o'clock in the morning, Charlie and Harrigan time, and we... Wait a minute. There's the...
Good heavens, what is that?
That's the emergency call from Herman Wurlitzer's mobile unit.
Of course.
The Charlie and Harrigan mobile unit, number 17. Is that...
Yeah, that's it.
That's important. That's cool. I think that's the one. Yeah, that's it. That means he's got a story, so we
better... That's a three-trumpet call. Let's get him in. Herman Wurlitzer, if you hear me in the mobile unit, will you come in, please?
Hey, Harrigan reporting to you from the Charlie and Harrigan Purple and White mobile unit. And I'd like to ask something of you, Charlie and Harrigan, if I could, just a moment, please.
Yes, Herman. Yes, Herman.
I'd like to ask a favor of you, please.
You just come on with the story, Herman. We're ready.
Herman, roll them.
The lines are open and you're on.
Roll them, Herman.
Well, it's not exactly a news story that I have for you, Mr. Rob Harrigan.
I know it's got to be important, Herman. You gave us the three-trumpet call.
It turns out that since I've been in Dallas, it seems that they've changed the highway patterns just a small amount since I've been here before.
Well, what kind of a story is that? I know they've changed the highways. That's
well,
not a bulletin.
It seems that I'm in a slight bind, Charlie and Harrigan. I could use your aid, if possible.
Shorty, I don't know what you're doing over there, but you'd better hurry up.
Could you tell the loudmouth of the studio to climb up, please?
All right, I certainly will. Herman,
I'll pass that along for you.
What
Herman.
Are you doing, Herman?
I'm on this beautiful new road that was heading toward down toward Stubbins Freeway. You'll recall where the Cabana Motel is. And I've got to this place, and they're asking for money.
You're on the toll road.
I beg your pardon?
You're on the toll road.
Say what?
Say toll road. You are on the toll road.
Toll road.
Toll.
You said it. Well, I find myself with an unfortunate case of insufficient funds, Charlie and Harrigan.
Insufficient?
They're asking for 20 cents to get off of this thing, and I'm afraid I don't have it with me.
Well, I don't know how to get you the 20 cents unless we...
I had 2 dimes, and I spent it on gas.
Are you still burning Hancock regular?
Yes, I am.
Well, it's that lack of planning that gets you into the difficulties that you're in now.
Well, I wondered if you might send the young squirt out here, because if you don't, they're going to take my spare tire.
The paint sale of the year is on right now at Sears. You'll find the lowest prices of the year available on 2 great latex paints, one for your home's interior, the other for its exterior. They are both reduced $3.11 this weekend only. The interior paint that regularly sells for $7.99 a gallon is on sale for just $4.88. The exterior paint is reduced from $8.99 to $5.88. Both paints flow on smoothly and easily, cover in one coat, dry in half an hour, and clean up easily with soap and water. Both are top quality latex paints. Both will give a beautiful velvety smooth finish that will last for years. And they're both on sale at the lowest prices of the year during Sears pre-Labor Day paint sale. Now in progress at all Sears stores in Dallas, Fort Worth, Arlington, Irving, and Denton.
Sears has everything.
KLIF 1190.
As long as we are reliving the year 1961, in all seriousness, this was the largest selling recording of the year 1961. Them was the day.
I think it's really nice of the McLendon organization to allow us to come back and lay complete waste to the mighty 1190. Roddy and Teicher, of course, in Exodus, 21 minutes after 8 o'clock in the morning. It's a good Friday morning, nice weather, and the whole weekend looks very, very good as far as weather is concerned. I'm Irving Harrigan, he's Charlie Brown, back together again with our entire cast and crew of years gone by. Nice to have you along, too.
Yes, and they're playing our song.
Now you can cash your payroll and personal checks at all A&A liquor stores. As an extra customer convenience, A&A has arranged for the telecheck cashing service at all stores. You'll need a telecheck identification card, but that's no problem, because you can get one free from any A&A store. With telecheck authorization, your checks will be cashed quickly and without questions or embarrassment. So if you need a check cashed, come in and see them. And in case you haven't heard, they have all the famous brands and plenty of ice-cold beer, as well as picnic supplies and snacks. A&A Liquor Stores, Dallas' largest and finest chain of package stores.
Oh, I was just looking at this little piece of a souvenir from the past.
Oh, is that? What is that?
That's a coffee cup that says Ken Tiger Knox on the side. Do you see that?
This is Charlie and Harrigan show.
Huh?
I said, is this the Charlie and Harrigan show, or is this still the Art Theater?
No, it's the Charlie and Harrigan show this morning.
It's the Charlie and Harrigan Concourse Theater, of course.
Well, all right, this is the right place, then.
What do you mean, the right place?
Well, they sent me over here with this press release.
Press release?
From City Hall.
From City Hall?
From City Hall, yeah. They've finalized their plans. They're going to go through with the new City Hall and build it.
Memorial?
This is the one where they cleared all the area.
Why, certainly.
We paraded by there this morning about 3:23. We went
right
past
across
there.
For Memorial Auditorium.
They're clearing that area out for the big City Hall. They've had a lot of financial problems from what I've been able to read about it.
Right.
Well, that's the trouble, you know.
And you have a really, you have, what, is there news?
We've been in an all-night session, and it's in the cellar, and we've really come up with the plan. We think now that we can really float this thing and get it going, and we wanted to let you boys be the first to know.
Exclusive, as it were, eh?
Very nice of you to come by. They've had a lot of trouble. I know they had several plans. They were going to build a smaller city hall at one point because the funds weren't available for the big one.
There wasn't enough money to get...
That's right. We're going to go... We have three different plans.
Uh-huh.
And we're going to do the smaller city hall, but it didn't hold all the facilities that we wanted to put in there.
Well, wasn't there something in about a big one but not a complete one or something?
We're going to build a shell, is what we call it. A shell, and we're going to put the whole big building, but then we're going to finish it off on the inside.
Is that the plan?
Kind of like a Jim Walter home approach.
Yes, is that the plan?
Well, no. We come up with something better than that.
Something better than that, but you do have a final solution to the problem, do you?
We think so. We've figured a way to get a city hall that is as big as we want it to be, and yet at low cost. We cut a few corners and we've had to redo the architectural drawings a little bit.
Well, now the big problem has always been getting enough financing to get the materials, the construction. You never have enough money to really build one as big. You've solved that problem?
We've whipped that, yes. We're ready to go ahead right now.
And it's going to be a really big place with
all... It's going to be big, yeah. A little simple, but very big.
How did you get to the solution? How did you figure it out?
What we're going to do is we're going to buy 2,000 porta cans and rip out the partitions.
Hey, do you understand this whole bad grammar thing? You know, Winston tastes good like a cigarette should versus as a cigarette should. Frankly, this preposition-proposition confuses me the way I see it. What do you want? Good grammar or good taste? Come on now. What do you want? Good grammar or good taste? Regarding the preposition, pardon our grammar, but Winston tastes good. Here it comes, like a cigarette should. Winston may not say it right, but they sure know how to make it right. Winston tastes good, watch out, like a cigarette should. Faced with a proposition like that, who cares about a little old preposition?
The KLIF 1190 in Dallas, and of course Johnny Dark is going to be coming in soon, and a host of regulars, ladies and gentlemen, and all stars from the past.
Jim O'Brien's coming back from 12 to 3. Let's see, Dean O'Day will be back from 3 to 6.
The Rabbit is coming in this evening.
The Rabbit, Russ Knight, the Weird Beard.
I was with the Weird Beard last night. The Weird Beard has promised to come in and will be here very soon, very
good,
soon.
Good, and Chuck Boyles will be on doing the talk show for those of you who love hate, and then of course the Coyote. We'll be on from, 2 in the morning until 6 in the morning for those of you who dig bad breath.
It's now Chevrolet savings time. The time to save on all the Novas your Chevy dealer has in stock. Some months ago, Nova's price was reduced by $159. based on manufacturer's suggested retail prices, including federal excise tax and suggested dealer new vehicle preparation charges. Destination charges, state and local taxes, and optional equipment additional. Your dealer may have some of these Novas left, but you better hurry, because with summer clearance deals, you'll save even more. Test price a Nova during Chevrolet Savings Time, while time is on your side.
You're mine, and we belong together. Yes, we belong together for all eternity.
Jimmy Velvet.
You remember the Players Club? It's about a minute before 8:30 in the morning on KLIF, and they say that, don't they? We don't even have to say that anymore.
Station break, yes.
The station break has been taken out of our hands.
Well, I don't know that Dick Mock knows that. Perhaps we should say KLIF in Dallas in the event he, you know, misses it, just coming in from the West Coast and all. He might not throw one in, or he might, for that matter, identify the station he's working for, you know?
Mm-hmm. That's good, too. We've all... Hey, matter of fact, come to think of it, gee whiz, it's been a long time since we've all gotten together, and I noted down there that in honor of our return, that Sam of Sam's Barbecue has made a reappearance, a guest appearance, and we'll be serving his barbecue all day long today, and they took his apron that had been standing in the corner since we left, and he's got it back on again.
Oh, that's fantastic. I'm glad they say that. They had told me that they were
going to use it as a picnic table, but...
In a world of men and women... I was neither. I was a woman trapped in the body of a man. And there was only one escape.
George Jorgensen became Christine Jorgensen with the world's first sex change operation. But did the surgeon's knife make him a woman or a freak? The Christine Jorgensen story. First man to become a woman. In color from United Artists. Rated R. Under 17, not admitted without parent.
Second week at the Apollo Astro Capri Century Gemini Plano in East Maine.
8:30 in Dallas, and as you fight the traffic this morning, you should know these things from KLIF News. Thousands of young people gather outside a Portland, Oregon convention center, hoping to disrupt an American Legion convention there today. Police are ready, so they say. Vice President Spiro Agnew says we, the United States, will continue to supply Cambodia with military aid until Saigon freezes over if necessary. A Senate vote for noon. Whether or not to put a $66 billion ceiling on defense spending. An underground group has claimed credit for that Madison, Wisconsin University bombing this week, and they say there will be more of the same unless their demands are met by October 30th. In case you forgot, schools are open, the kids are out there, and you better drive slower, please. KLIF weather after this.
Gosh, Cheryl, you're really something.
No,
I mean it. You're really something. I mean, you know just everything. You fixed the refrigerator.
Oh, yeah, well, I just plugged it in, you know.
Yes, but you knew right away what was wrong. I mean, you just figured it out.
Gladys.
No, really, Harold. And tonight, the way you perked up everything we had for supper, just suggesting I use some accent.
Yeah.
The salad, the potatoes, the sombrero steak. Oh. I mean, who would have thought that accent even works on cucumber soup? Harold, I mean, you never cease to amaze me, really. Are you married?
Huh? A little accent, like a little love, surely helps.
Accent, that amazing product that always brings out the natural lean meat goodness of beef tenderloin, rump roast, lamb chops, flank steak, beef stroganoff.
Cliffland weather fair through most of the weekend with some high cloudiness. High today 92, low tonight 68. Current Dallas Love Field temperature 71 degrees. In Fort Worth 68, at Cliffland downtown 73. This is Richard Mock for KLIF Fun Day News.
At birth, mom and papa call her little boy Ned. Raise him on the banks of a river bed. A houseboat and tied to a big tall tree. A home for my papa and my mama and me. The clock strikes three, papa jumps to his feet. Already mama's cooking papa something to eat. At half past papa, he's ready to go. He jumps in his bureau, headed down the bayou. He's got fishing lines strung across the loose.